What's going on YouTube? Jeans here, bringing you guys some more content for Pokemon Sword and Shield. And ladies and gentlemen, today's video, it's a banger. Let me tell you that right now. We got ourselves an awesome team right here. If you guys look up in that top left corner, you could see we got the giant T-Rex mon over here. Tyrantrum, one of my favorite fossil Pokemon. Looking dope, looking spiffy, and ready to get after it. So if you guys are hyped, make sure you support the channel by smashing that like button and clicking that big red subscribe button. Seriously, it goes a long way. Thank you guys so much for the support. You guys seriously rock. You guys have no idea how much your support means to me. But this team was sent in once again by my boy Gale. Gale, thank you for dropping another team. Shout out to you. I've been loving the teams you've been sent in. I cannot wait to get after it with this team. But first spot, we got our boy T-Rex Tyrantrum over here with strong draw ability, weakness policy as an item, and then also moveset of Rock Slide, Dragon Claw, and Fire Fang, and then Protect as that final move. But yo, I love this typing on this Pokemon. Rock and Dragon, like, he might be the only Rock and Dragon Pokemon in the game. Like, I cannot think of another one. So if you guys do know one, let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to know. We also got two Ultra Beasts on this team with Celesteela and Xerxatree. Celesteela over here with the Leftovers, Beast Boost ability, Heavy Slam, EQ, Leech Seed, and Protect. Nothing new for that. Xerxatree with the Beast Boost and the Focus Sash. Electric typing with Thunderbolt and Bolt Switch, both for Stab, Dazzling Gleam, and Energy Ball for coverage. Bottom right corner, we got our boy Dusclops. You guys already know so much about Dusclops. Like, I don't even need to, like, go over Dusclops. Trick Room Mon right there with Evo Light. That's all you guys need to know. Amoongus in the bottom left corner. Nice little support mon with Effect Spore, Koba Berry, Rage Powder, Spore, Giga Drain, and Sludge Bomb. And then in the final spot, one of the best Series 7 Pokemon, in my opinion, we got Glaciary over here with the Life Orb, Chillinay, Icicle Crash, High Horsepower, Heavy Slam, and Protect. But guys, you want to use this team for yourself? You guys already know the deal. Rent the code is at the bottom of the screen. If you do end up using it, let me know in the comment section down below how you guys do with it. But without further ado, let's hop onto that Ranked Double Ladder and get some wins with this T-Rex team. First battle coming at you guys, and this guy's got a pretty strong team. He's got the Dragapult, the Tapu-Fini, Urshifu, Rotom Pizza Oven, he's got Jelly Boy, and then a Clefairy. I definitely got set up for Trick Room. I definitely gotta go for Trick Room. I don't think he has anybody who can imprison it or cancel out Trick Room, so we're gonna be thriving with that. Can he proc his own weakness policy with a Dragapult and double my Dusclops? I don't see any Pokemon that's gonna proc his weakness policy. I really do not see that happening, so I'm gonna go Dusclops and Tyrantrum, try to set up Trick Room, and then maybe proc my own weakness policy with Brick Break, and roll from there. And then if we have Trick Room rolling, I kind of want Glacier. And then in the final spot, either Xerxatree or Amoongus. Amoongus isn't a bad one with all the Rage Powder he can thrive out with. I think it's fine. I think it's fine to go into Amoongus. I think he does work. Let's get after it, yo. I'm liking it. Two support mons and two heavy hitters with the Glacier Life Orb and the weakness policy Tyrantrum. Yo, it's looking good. It's looking good. But I wonder who he's going to start off with. I wonder who he's going to lead. I really do. If he leads at Clefairy, I'm kind of fine with it because we can get a free Trick Room turn set up. And then I can eventually go into like the Brick Break into my Tyrantrum. I might just Protect Turn 1. Let's see who he actually goes in with. He's going to go with... Okay. Rotom Heat and Nihilego over here. Jelly Belly, dude. Does this thing learn Trick Room? It might learn Trick Room. It's Poison and Rock, so I don't think it learns Trick Room. Like, that's weird. But I have an odd feeling it does. So I'm just going to Protect here. You're gonna get thriving after this. And I'm just gonna Trick Room. I'm just gonna Trick Room, man. You give me no option not to just go into a Trick Room. I think my boy can eat up both shots of an Overheat and whatever Jelly Boy has to offer. But he might just Dynamax and go after his Dusclops. Let's see what he does. Hopefully he tries to throw a shot over on the Tyrantrum slot. I'm trying to get this Trick Room off, then Brick Break, and then we'll Wild after. Because we can drop a Rocket Stab. These guys are both special attackers, so I really don't want to drop a Worm Wind to lower attack. I'd rather get the Sandstorm set up. That'll actually help me out a little bit more. But make a move. Make a move! We're getting off early today. Let's get it. Tyrantrum, bang. Protect. You're protecting out here. Meteor Beam coming out here. Oh, yo, this thing's dropping a Meteor Beam? Does it have the Power Herb? That's a real question. Does it have the Power Herb? It does have the Power Herb. Okay, so this thing's sending it. Go after my Tyrantrum. Yes! Yeah, yo! Wasted all that. Nancy Plot, this thing's setting up. Trick Room's here. Who do I take out? Who do I take out is the real question. Someone's gotta go. This thing's plotted. These guys are set up. We're Trick Room. I'm gonna have to proc weakness policy and roll from here. But I have to choose who I want out of here. I think I definitely go for the Rock Fall over and take out him. He's plus two. Kind of poses a big threat. And then I just Brick Break into my Tyrantrum and we Dynamax. And we get rolling with that. The Trick Room's here. We got speed. We're thriving a little bit. Tyrantrum's gonna have a decent amount of HP. Looking good, yo, dude. He looks fire, dude. He looks so good in blue. Like, he's looking amazing. He's looking amazing. Like, the shiny Tyrantrum is so cool. Such cool looking Pokemon. I always hate the shiny Pokemon. Like, me and my buddy were talking about this. That just, like, changed their tint a little bit. Like, you work so hard to get a shiny, and some of them are just, like, a lighter shade of blue of what they normally are. You're just like, bro, yo, get out of my face. I don't like that at all. I like when they're, like, totally different colors, and they're looking like totally different Pokemon. Like, it just makes game or shinies look so much cooler. But this dude's set up pretty well, too. Like, this is, like, this one's gonna be close. We do have the Trick Room. And I believe Tyrantrum will just dump on this Rotom, no problem. But that Nihilego is posing a threat. He might be Focus Sash as well. That Meteor Beam is stabbed. He's plus one right now. Rotom's plus two. We're about to be plus two on the board. And we have speed advantage. Big boy, 376. Yo, this is my favorite fossil Pokemon. Seriously, yo, question of the day right now. Who's your favorite fossil Pokemon right now? Mine is Tyrantrum. I don't think anybody topped him so far. He's just looking so cool. He's such a good one. But there we go. We got Weakness Policy proc in here. And it's part Dragon type, which I love. Rock Fall's coming out of here, which is a huge player. Get it, dropping it. Rotom should be dead. I don't think it's rocking Poké Sash. Yeah, get it out of my face. Yo, Rotom, out of my face, dude. We ain't having it today. Bang, Sandstorm set up, and I believe that will neglect some special attacking damage for Rock Pokemon, right? I believe that's how it goes. See what this thing goes for. Meteor Beam's gonna shoot across here. That's totally fine. He's gotta charge up again. He can't just shoot it off. I'm cool with that. I think I take out this thing. I don't want this thing setting up. I think I just Nightshade and then dump on it, right? And hopefully he throws out a physical attacker, because if he does, then I drop a Wyrmwind and we roll from there. Let's see what goes in there. Dragon Pole, beautiful. Do I dump on the Dragon Pole instead? I kind of want you out the way. I'm going to go here, and I'm just going to Nightshade. I think that's the play. What happens? Or is he gonna Dynamax Dragon Ball? He might guard. I can see him guarding here. But this might have been a bad play. But both these Pokemon are very, very, like, they're big threats right now. A stab, Meteor Beam, that's big damage. And he's plus two. If I can get this thing's clear body, so minus one. But still, I just thought this thing was maybe guarding or something along the line. Let's see what he does. Let's see what his play is. He gonna guard? He does not guard. We're gonna get rid of this thing. We're gonna get rid of this boy right here. And then we're going to be able to drop a Wyrmwind, say see you later to that. And hopefully he goes after Dusclops. We probably could have just dumped on the Dragon Pole. We probably could have just took that thing out, which would have been huge. But hopefully he goes after Dusclops like a Phantasm or something. See what he goes for. Nope, he's going to go for that Wyrmwind. Over on to me. Can we eat? Eat it up, buddy. You're the best. I love you. Eat it up. We all 51. We're going to be able to go first and thrive out after this. Unless he has a first turn priority move, which could be scary. We're still plus one. I can still do work on that thing. This thing is Life Orb, so no policy procking. We're thriving here. Tyrantrum. Too good, baby. Too good. Now, who's his final mind? This could be a big deciding factor. The Clefairy? Is it somebody with first turn priority? Let's see. It's Urshifu. Yeah. Unless he's rocking Aqua Jet. We don't get Ampers. I could just Brick Break that thing. But I'd rather just like go into a Nightshade and double up into this thing right here. Please don't be rocking Aqua Jet. I hope not. Let's see. It's Rocket Sucker Punch. Dang, man. This game's trash. Maybe I should have protected. Oh, this one's going to be super, super close now. This one's going to be super, super close. Nightshade coming out here. I think we save my boy for the back end. He's going to Phantasm take me out. Actually, we might be able to eat. Let's see. Do not eat. This thing's tanking. Man, dude, we should just took out the Dragon Bolt. I feel like Nihilego posed a big threat as well, as that thing went up plus two. But the buffets are popping. He still has one more turn in this thing. We still have Trick Room rolling here. And we have Glacier. We have Glacier and Amoongus all day. And I think a nice little Icicle Crash could take out, what's it called? All day. Take out Dragon Bolt. I think I just Rage Powder this one, and we go after this Dragon Bolt. I'm not trying to deal with that Urshifu coming in with the close combat on me. I'd rather do this and then just Rage Powder out. That's the play, I believe. Let's get it. Rage Powdering up. Is this thing going to guard? This thing actually might guard. Oh, that would be the play. If he guards and then Trick Room's over, then that's scary. Please don't guard. I don't think he has the moxie to guard. I don't think he has it in him to pull that play. He's going to detect. Yeah, I knew you didn't have the moxie. I knew you didn't have it. I knew you didn't. Oh, he has the moxie. He double protects. Okay, that's fine. I think we're out of Trick Room turns, which is scary. Or do we have one more? That would be lovely if we have one more. That would be super lovely if we have one more. Show me one more. Show me one more turn. I don't think we do. Buffets are going around. They going around. Please, one more turn. That's all I'm asking. We do not have one more turn. Okay. Now, the thing is here. We go after Dragapult Slap. I think we have to. I think he might go into a Phantom Force. That's the scary part, if he drops through the Phantom Force. Which I think he might do. So in this case, I'm going to protect. And I think I just spore over on... I think it's Unseen Fist. I cannot protect. I have to rage battle. I can't protect. But I think he's going to drop into a Phantom Force, which is scary. Which is very, very scary. Let's see what he does. Do not do it. He's going to fly. I want to spore and protect. I feel like that would have been the play, but Wicked Blow's gonna come out here. Go, baby. Eat that. Eat it all day. Gets a crit. That's a guaranteed crit. This one's gonna be super close. Vex Spore coming in. Oh, I forgot about the Vex Spore ability. That's huge. Play now is going to be not even Rage Powder. I don't even think we Rage Powder. I think we drop Icicle Crash here. And we can just go for a Giga Drain. We just go for a Giga Drain over on the slot. Oh my god, Effect Spore. Eating up, baby. Let's go, Amoongus. He playing around. Fly comes through. Come on, Barry. I still think we're dead. Yeah, Barry takes out. Yo, dude, this one's going to be super, super close. That puts him to sleep. Oh my lord. Yo, if this Urshifu... This Urshifu's going to have quick naps. I'm going to lose. I already know it. Let's go. We need this to hit. Hopefully it hits. They're all slumped. They're all slumber bumbers. Icicle Crash comes through. Yep, connects. Dragon pulled out the way. Hold up. Wait a minute. It is coming down. So that's one turn sleep. We need him just to be, I think, sleep for two turns, I think. Actually, we're boosted now. Now the question is, I think I have to drop an Icicle Crash. Go for the stab shots over anything. Yeah, we're going for Ice Clash. Come on, baby. You're sleeped. You're night-night. NyQuil. Yeah. Come on, Landis. Yeah, come on. Come on, baby. Give it to Jeans. I'm the best. I am the best Pokemon player on planet Earth. Amoongus coming up OP with Effect Spore, dude. And I was going to say in the beginning of the video, I wish this thing had a regenerator. Nah, yo. Effect Spore is where it's at. Big clutch in that last battle. Let's get it. Starting off this video 1-0. We're hopping into our second battle here. This guy's got a strong team, though. Look at his team. He's got Landorus, Incineroar, Regieleki, Tapu Fini, Galarian Moltres, and Metagross. Like, that team's looking insane. Two Intimidate Pokemon, which is kind of scary. It really is scary, considering I have big physical attacking team. Like, big physical attacking team. So, I think this one's over with. How do we, like, counter up on this? Like, I just don't know. I guess our weakness policy is going to have to come out here and clutch up for us. Other than that, like, this one seems really tough. We're going to have to set up a Trick Room. We're going to go Tyrantrum in the first spot. We're going to go Amoongus. No, not Amoongus. Xerxatree. We definitely need Special Attacker. And you're physical, aren't you? Oh, you're physical attacking. Big bulky defense, but... Glacier is physical. Actually, no. It might be Special. No, I think it's physical. High horsepower and all that? Yeah, this thing's totally good. I think we still want to go in maybe Glacier. We need another heavy hitter. Or do we go in Amoongus, try to catch up with him again? I think Glacier is the play, even though, like, two Intimidate off this team is just... There's nothing we can really do about it. Like, this is just gonna... I feel like we lose this one due to Intimidate drops. They're just gonna come up big and just roll on me. He's got two Pokemon with it. We have no Defiant. We have no Competitive. We have nothing to really, like, pose a big threat towards it. And this guy's probably sees it because we're in Master Ball tier. And he's just going to steamroll us, I think. I think that's what's going to happen. He's probably going to lead somebody. Top of Finny and Incineroar. Yeah. Man, what you mean? I hate this game, man. I hate it so much. I think he's just parting shot. Dude, he's got this one. He's chilling. Misty Surge is popping. And then he's got Top of Finny right here. And Top of Finny's so good. I think I just protect and set up a Trick Room. I think that's the play. Intimidate's going to be... Gonna do us dirty this game. It really is. It really is going to be doing us dirty all game long. First, gonna come out here. And the only way I can actually kind of get out of this situation is going to be just this weakness policy just dominate and doing work. So I'm just going to Trick Room here. I'm going to Protect. Or I could drop a Rock Slide. I could always drop a Rock Slide, but I do not really think that's a play with the Tapu Fini on the board. I just don't see that thing doing work. He might just swap right into Landorus, which is scary. We get a nice Protect. Out here, Incineroar is going to fake out. Get out of my face. Tapu Fini's probably going to come after us as well. Tapu Fini's going to roll a Trick and take out my Ebolite. That's actually fine. You can have my Ebolite. Let's cops obtain a choice back. Are you kidding me? Am I choice spec'd into that? Okay, Brick Break now. What the? Get out of my face! This game's trash! We can't even proc weakness policy now? What you mean? I don't understand. I guess I'm rock sliding now. I'm getting Xerxatry out here. This game is whack. Dustcops, get it. You're done. You're like, you can't do anything, Dustcops. You're truly expecting him to a Trick Room. We get out Xerxatry. This thing's looking spiffy with the shininess. Parting Shot's coming out here. Chill on me. Your Parting Shot into him? That was smart, predicting the swap? Yo, what? This dude's nasty. He's probably going to get out Landorus. Like, oh my lord. This dude's nasty. It's over. It is over. I don't know what to do. It is just over with. This game is over. Rockside's going to do absolutely nothing. Maybe get a flinch on Finny. That would be huge. I really don't know what to do. I'm going to keep Xerxatry out here. Xerxatry actually can't do anything. He can't do anything. Actually, I can just drop a T-Bolt. Actually, I'm just going to Bolt Switch onto the Finny slot. And I think I just Protect. But you know what, dude? I don't need Dustcops. I'm just going to swap Dustcops in. Jesus, man. Dude, this game. We're going to have to keep swapping, dude. This guy's got us on the ropes hard. This guy's on the ropes really hard here. We're going to Frisk. You see the Ebolite over there. Can that thing actually hold an Ebolite? No, it cannot, because it doesn't even evolve. What the? I just don't get it right now. Like, this dude just coming out here. He has a fake out next turn. I'm going to Volt Switch into... I think Glacier is going to be the Volt Switch Pokemon here. No, he's going for a ground move. He's going for a ground move right now, so... Definitely got to go into Tyrantrum. He's going into a ground move on me. Probably going to drop... I actually hope you're dropping EQ. I really do wonder what you're going with. He can fake out next turn, so I could just Protect. Rock Slide's coming out here. He is going to fake me out, so it's just like, bruh. I have no idea what to do. I just don't know. I said we get my boy Glacier out here. Like, I can't do anything. I simply can't move. My Dustcops is choice spec. It's into a Trick Room, and I can't do anything whatsoever. He's going to withdraw Landorus. He's going to come back out next turn and just be doing the same thing every single play. I just don't know what to do. I guess I have to Dynamax here. I think I have to Dynamax here. Is the fake out coming out? Yeah, the fake out's coming out. I'm going to Dynamax here. I'm going to have to Dynamax. I'm going to have to take somebody out. I'm going to have to get an Ampharos. Oh, man, dude. This game's tough. We're going to Dynamax here. I think I'm going to Quake. I think I Quake here, and if I take out Incineroar, that's a huge play for me, that's a huge plus, and I get a Chilling Knight, and then I can counter up on that Intimidate. This is like our only way out, but right now, I just can't do anything. It's just terrible. This game's really bad right now. He's going to withdraw Finny. I like to see that. I like to see that all day. He's going to get back out Landers. I saw that coming all day. Like, I see that. Intimidate's coming out here. We already know that. Like, I said this. Beginning of the match, before we even pick Pokemon, I said Intimidate's gonna be a problem here. But yo, if I win this game, just know I'm the best Pokemon player on the planet Earth. If I win this game, every person who's watching who's not subscribed has to click that subscribe button. If I lose this game, every person who's watching this video and is not subscribed has to hit that subscribe button. It works both ways. If you guys aren't subscribed, hit that subscribe button. You know your boy's making fire content for you guys. Max Quake coming out here. Get this Incineroar out of here. Please dump on it. Tell it to go home. Give me my Chilling Egg. Give it. good. I'm too good. I'm too good at this game. I'm too good. I'm too good. If I win this game for the online gaming community, baby. Back to normal. Back to normal. One intimidate Pokemon gone. One of them out of here. Rock Slide popping. Yes, sir. Doing some damage. You like to see that. You love it. Love to see it. No more trickling. Play here. I already know what the play is. We swap Tyrantrum out of here. We get Duskops in here. Once we get Duskops in here, we set up another trickling. We get the Ryben. He's going to go into a Pokemon that's going to try to do some work up against my boy right here. I already know that. So in that case, we still swap. We get out my boy, Duskops. He's going to Dynamax Metagross. I see that coming all day. I'm going to set the hail. Gene's going to set the hail. We're going to take out Landorus. Tell him to go home. I think it's the play. I feel like I'm talking like President Obama or something like that. That's how he talks. He like talks sentences. He's like, okay. We're going to use Max Hailstorm. And then we're going to use it on Landorus. And then we do this. That's how he talks. He's going to swap Landorus. Of course. Should have saw that coming. He's going to go back out into the top of Finny. That's a tough play. Bruh. But now I'm going to be talking like President Obama for the rest of the match. Top of Finny uses the Misty Surge. That's fine. That is fine. The Misty Swirls swirl around the battlefield. I ran some swaps. The Sclops goes in. That's how he speaks. But we're fine. I got a lot of energy. Feeling good. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the content. Gonna reveal my stuff and things. And here comes the Dynamax, which is pretty scary. I think I have to guard next turn. Like, this one's such a tough match. For a split second there, I thought maybe we had a shot at winning it. But now it's not looking so good for us. Got ahead of myself. And I should have known he was swapping. We are equal. We are even. He's going to go for a Steel Spike. He's going to boost defense. Eat this up, buddy. God dang, Metagross is too strong. It's just too strong. He gets a crit. Man, dude. I thought we were going to eat that up. And then he crits. And then he ruins my hopes. Ah, man. Man. What am I supposed to do now? Definitely got to set a trick room. Room that is full of tricks. Get out Zerx? Yeah, we are Sash. I say we get out Zerx and trick. We do have to set off that trick room. That's one of our last options here. Set off this trick room and roll from there. Trick room. Yeah. P-Bolt. Yeah. Oh, he's going to swap into Landers. I'm stupid. I should have just went for that energy ball. Gonna swap into Landorus, yeah. Cause I'm stupid, yeah. Bruh, I still see like a glimmer of hope in this battle, but he doesn't have to swap. And he swapped. Ah. E! God, man. And I even said it. And your boy even said it. Should've just went to the energy ball. We could've took that thing out. We could've been thriving. Now Zerk's tree's gonna get a little claps on. But still, yo, Trick Room's popping now. Oh, you're gonna go after him. Is that another crit? Oh, no, we don't have Evo Light. Never mind. We do not have Evo Light. Wrap it up. This one is over with, man. Thunderbolts can come through. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. I totally forgot. We did not have that Evo Light. But, dude, we actually put up a pretty good fight there, considering we probably had, like, a 0.6% chance of even killing a Pokemon with all these Intimidates out here. But Protect. Oh, screw this guy. We're going for this. Even though I think we're just dead. Oh, we're getting after this Metagross. I want this Metagross out of my face. Hopefully Landorus, like, flies or something, distracts himself for a turn. But no way. He's going to be dropping probably Rock Slide or something. Yeah, here comes the Rock Slide. Zerxia's Tree avoids. My boy can eat this all day. Tyrantrum says, yo, dude, that's a tasty snack. Go after my Zerxia Tree. Ah, okay, now that's good. That's definitely good. Wrap it up. I need him to go after the Zerxia Tree and us to eat. And then maybe pick up a kill here. But I didn't think we were killing with the Fire Fang. It's not Stab. This thing's really, really bulky. But Zerxia Tree's coming out here with the T-Volt. Watch, he would have got the Paralyze. Oh, dang, yo, nice damage, Zerx. Zerx, don't be, he ain't playing around. He's not playing around, but dude, I think that crit kind of that muffed us up a little bit there too, on my Glacier. But yeah, tough battle. I kind of knew we weren't really gonna win that one. That was really really tough. But we did actually put up a really good fight. So I surprised myself there. Let me know in the comment section down below if you guys thought for a split second that I was actually gonna win that second battle under those circumstances. But we're gonna hop into our third and final battle, run for this one, and try to get ourselves a winning record for this video. Third and final battle coming at you guys, and you guys already know we're looking for that win for the pause for dramatic effect. Jean's online gaming community, baby. We looking for it for you guys. This guy is Mammoth Swine. Mammoth Swine is an absolute beast. He's got the Clefairy. He has no Trick Room team here. He has no, or Trick Room Pokemon, I should say. He has a Draco Fish, maybe Sandrush, maybe Strongjawed. I do not know. He's got the other form of the horse, the Spectrier, I believe it's called. I think we go Duskops again and Tyrantrum. Set that Trick Room. Try to get rolling off with that. The thing, or Mammoth Swine's going to be Oblivious, so gotta remember that. Glacier, does Glacier come in? I think Xerxitree comes back. Round two. I think Glacier comes in as final spot. But Glacier is just really strong. It's an absolute beast. Is that the call? It's called, baby. I'm liking it. Feeling good. Looking good. We can roll. The real question is, no, we're thriving. I think we're fine. Because I was going to say, if he leads Trick Room, you can just dump on my Tyrantrum. But no, I just protect. I set the Trick Room. And then I roll out after that. Proc Weakness Policy and dump on the Trick Room. And then we're fine. But I feel like this lead covers a lot of different options. So we can just protect it. I mean, unless Urshifu does come in here. And then if Urshifu does come in here, then I might just swap. I might swap. Get the Trick Room and then swap. Maybe try to get Xerxitree out there because it is Sash. But let's see who he leads. Please don't lead Urshifu. That would actually screw me over. Tough news, man. Tough news. I think I just Dynamax Tyrantrum. Let him punch on me? Do I let him punch on me? Or is fighting super... I feel like fighting is still super effective. Definitely gotta set Trick Room. I think I still Dynamax and I go just get after it. I could take out the Celesteel. Let's tell it to go home. I say we do that. I say we tell Celesteel to go home. Instead of swapping, let's do this. I think he's gonna try to drop me with like close combat and probably proc my weakness policy. Let's see what he does. If he detects, he detects. If not, we get a free shot off. Which I'm totally fine with. Let's see what he does. We're Dynamaxing. We get after it, baby. We get after it. Celesteel, I would love the second draw on Celesteel. I don't think he has any big fire Pokemon threat, so this will only help our coverage move. 376, big HP, big dinosaur here, looking all cool. And then we gonna get after. Ooh, he's gonna Dynamax as well. Now we're sitting a little scared. He might go for his big move, his big G-Max move. See what he does. I know he's Dynamaxing Celesteel. Ew. Oh there. He's gonna proc my weakness policy. But he's gonna go last. That's a problem. He's gonna go last. Tyrantrum will be able to outspeed. Let's see what happens here. Get after it. Urshifu's gonna go for a Wicked Blow. We should be able to eat this up. I just survived on one. And that dude's probably fuming. He's probably fuming. I just survived on one. And I'm a pain split next turn. Oh no. Oh no. No, 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 no. This thing's policied. He's gonna take me out. He's gonna steal Spike and take me out. Go after Duskops, please. Okay, he went after Duskops. We don't get to trick him off. Okay. Alright. Jeans, what do we do? I don't know. This one's looking real tough. Ooh! Hey! One might be over with, boys. One might be over with. Gotta get out, Xerx. I mean, Xerx actually is pretty fast. Let me see Xerx, he's something. 103, he's not gonna outspeed at everything. Unless they double up into him, but I don't think they're gonna double up into him. We guard? Do I guard? He's plus three. He's plus three in special attack right now. Terrifying. And I think I have to drop a T-Bolt. I think I have to flare. I think I have to do both of these. Celesteel, there's no way you're guarding. Just don't see that happen. There is no Trick Room, so he's gonna go last. Mother... Ah, what you mean? Ah! I didn't say it, though. All I said was mother, so you know. I didn't finish the sentence. Oh, dude! Kidding me? Ah, dude, we're getting whomped. We're getting murked right now. We're getting murked. This one's over with. Evolt's gonna have to come out here. I guess we'll double up in a Celesteel. Hopefully, take it out. We need Celesteel out of here if we're gonna do anything. Wicked Blow's gonna come in, dude. This Urshifu's a pain in my neck right now. Just keeps Wicked Blowing and just dumping on me. Xerxes goes down. Things guaranteed crit, so I can't complain. Do we think he's gonna take out? We got the multiplier going here. Let's see. Come on, do it. Get him out of my face. Nope. Didn't even seem like it even did that much. More in the drought. Come Steel Spike, we're dead. That's an obvious. We're dead. And we're getting ran. We're getting ran for the third and final battle. It's tough news, guys. It's real tough news. That Max Guard just won the game. If I would have took out Urshifu, we would have been thriving. If I took out Urshifu, we're thriving. We would actually have a shot after that. Now all that's left. This thing's beast boosted, yo. I'm gonna keep my horsey alive. I'm not just gonna let my horsey die like that. I gotta run this one. You guys know the deal. There's no need to let a Pokemon die. You know you're gonna lose. Keep the Pokemon alive. Save its poor, restless soul, man. We need it here. But I'm gonna run. That's GG to this guy. This guy absolutely murked on me with Celesteel and Urshifu. And I said that in the beginning. I was like, dude, if he leads Urshifu, that's gonna be a tough little play for us. And he does. And we got 1 and 2. Not bad battles for today. The third one we got absolutely murked on. You guys just saw that. First battle was awesome. We won with a great battle. Second battle was really, really close considering that guy had Intimidates and kind of ran us. But we kept a good fight. We kept a good battle and got to show off a lot of good battles for today's video. I absolutely love this team. Gale, thank you so much for dropping it again. Like I said, Tyrantrum is probably my favorite fossil Pokemon. He's just such cool looking Pokemon, and the shiny form is fire. That blue on him was awesome. I love using him and love doing some big damage with him. But guys, that is going to be it for today's video. If you did enjoy the content, don't forget to smash that like button for me. And if you're new here, click that big red subscribe button so you know when my videos go live. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Peace out, everyone.